These are three vintage lithographic posters advertising the Great Southern Railways for travel to Ireland. These three lithographs are by Walter Till. They were not always in this good a shape. We linen backed and restored them. Watch how we did it.
What we're doing is laying the poster down on acid-free paper that has been mounted to stretched cotton canvas. This is what linen backing is. The poster is now absorbing the wheat paste that has been put on underneath it, and we are now going to drench it with more moisture so that the paper expands. I've never been to the land of the bogs and the little people, but I'd love to go someday.
Yeah. That's one of the reasons why it's so quiet. Plus, there's no trucks out there that are backing up much.
Yeah.
So we're supposed to get some snow this weekend.
Oh.
Come to Ireland. This poster, no, it's showing you the scenery of what you can see when you go places.
Yeah.
They sometimes show rails themselves, but often the British rail posters don't. One of the reasons why they're popular to buy is because they're strictly landscapes. And it's rare to see British rail posters that are horizontal like this. So it makes it even more appealing, theoretically. Someone's gonna send me a poster for The Quiet Man, which is a movie that John Wayne starred in. He's an Irish-American who got rich in America, and he goes back to Ireland for some reason. I can't remember what, but I saw it on Korean Airlines. I see more movies that way.
Yeah. And this.
Walter Till was born in 1880 and died in 1930. I've been searching around the internet and I found bits and pieces of information on him. Auction records show that Walter Till's work has been offered at auction multiple times, with realized prices ranging from $123 to $2,612, which was the record price for one of his works. Walter Till exhibited a total of 20 works with the Dublin Sketching Club and once at the RHA.
Done? Put it in the hall, my friend. Where it is warmer.
Yes, boss.
I like the sound of that.
Ooh, it's cool.
Thank you, Jinbei.
We're going to let these travel posters dry for a few days on the screen before we trim them down and do the touch-up.
Here's another Walter Till poster for Great Southern Railways.
These posters were printed in the late 20s or early 30s, and they are printed in lithography. The lithographic colors are very beautiful, and the blending of the various colors is very impressive. One of the reasons why these British Rail posters are popular in vintage poster fairs is because they tend to be horizontal. And a lot of vintage posters are not horizontal. They work as horizontal because they're landscapes. And of course, as a destination, Ireland is very popular. These posters don't require a lot of touch-up. They're in fairly good shape. I'm doing a little bit of fine-tuning to the edges because on some of these posters there is edge wear. Ireland, the land of romance. Ireland. You know, in the over 30 years that I've been restoring posters, these are really among the most beautiful horizontal format posters showing landscape. They're very subtle and fine. Walter Till is a good artist. I can't find anything about him on the internet, so I can't really talk about him. Oh, I just found another auction result. One of his posters for Ireland sold for $4,855, and another one, this one for Ballinahinch, sold for $3,089. Not bad for a poster.
Well, there you have it. Three marvelous lithographs advertising travel to Ireland, all linen-backed at Posterfix. This is Chris. After 30 years in business, I still look forward to seeing your posters. Send them along, and we'll take care of them.